Welcome to Mastering Solutions. I think this is a really fun question, and I'm sure you guys don't like me here. And I'm sure you guys don't like to hear me say that because it's homework and they can be difficult if you don't know what to do. So I think this is a really fun question to work through. We're just using a lot of geometry really to figure out logically what the reflected rays are going to do. We know that in a mirror, these are plane mirrors here, a light is going to be reflected and the angle of incidence and the angle of reflection are going to be the same. But remember, this is our normal, and that is where we always measure the angles from. And so this angle here is a 90 degree angle. And so we know that a 90 degree angle, that this angle and whatever our angle of incidence is going to be, they're going to be complementary and add to 90. And 90 degrees is equal to 35 degrees plus whatever that is, right? And to find this, it's just 90 degrees minus 35 degrees. And that is 55 degrees. And our angle of incidence is 55 degrees. But we know that the angle of reflection is also 55 degrees. So we've just formed another right triangle right there, right? So that means that this one is also going to be 35 degrees. You could have used geometry to figure out that these two angles are equal to each other, but we also proved it the way working around this way too. And so if this is 35 degrees, here is a 90 degree angle right there. And so that means this one is also going to be 55 degrees, because remember, the triangle has to add to 180. So we have 90, and then these two angles have to add up to be 90. So that means this one is 55 degrees, right? So now we're going to have the same thing. We're going to have the angle of incidence is the 55. Well, the angle of reflection is also going to be measured off of this one here. And lo and behold, we have another 90 degree angle right there. So if we have 55 degrees again, then that means this, as we've done several times already, is also 35 degrees. That gets reflected off like that. And so that means our angle of our theta of reflection is also going to be 35 degrees. So this is an angle of incidence right there, an angle of reflection right there. So these are 35 degrees, and then this one, by the same logic that we've done, is also going to be 55 degrees. So at what angle relative to the incoming ray to the outgoing does the outgoing ray emerge? So now we have figured out all of the angles in our figure here, but what is the answer then? And it all depends on what it's in relationship to. If we're talking about the vertical in relation to this mirror here, well, both of them are reflected, and I drew it a little bad. These rays should be parallel to each other because both the angle of incidence from this one and the angle of reflection respect to the vertical are going to be 35 degrees. But they say, what are they in? Is the outgoing ray in relationship to the incoming ray? And since they're parallel to each other, its relationship is 180 degrees, meaning it comes in, it reflects, and then bounces back in the opposite direction. So the answer for what they ask for is 180 degrees. But if you were asking in relationship to the normal, or if you're asking in relationship to the horizontal, it might have different answers for what they want, 180 degrees.